Hello guys, this is Kirill, your Justice Analyst, and today we are gonna take a look at another country taking part in the semifinals of Eurovision 2024. And today we're gonna take a look at the most European country from all the participants of the upcoming Eurovision Song Contest, and it's Australia. Well, of course, I'm joking, but basically since 2015, this country is every year invited by the European Broadcasting Union as a sort of special guest. In the very first edition where they took part, they actually were an automatic finalist because it was seen as just one-time gesture. But since it turned out to be a success and Australians were very much motivated to continue their participation, since 2016, they actually have to compete in the semifinals. And this year, Australia has finally chosen Electric Fields to represent them, who already tried to compete in 2019's edition, but unfortunately, or maybe luckily, lost in that selection to Kate Miller-Heidke with her Zero Gravity. I have to say, I was not a huge fan of that song 2000 and whatever back then. I was really happy that Kate won that selection, but I definitely appreciated their unique identity. Electric Fields is actually a musical duo consisting of two members. One is Zachariah Fielding, who is the vocalist, and another one is the producer, but also the keyboard player, Michael Ross. They are singing not only in English, but combining also it with some Aboriginal languages of Australia, which is super cool, which is something we have never heard in Eurovision, which I have never heard apart from listening to them at all in my life. So I am very much excited to hear what kind of entry they bring for this year. So this year, the Australian entry is written by the musicians themselves, which is, I think, always super cool. And it is called One Mikaeli or One Blood.
I stand in the eye of the spiral, one of the billions. My soul slips away from its title, one of the billions.
The vocal of Zachariah is actually so special. I still remember his voice, even though I haven't heard them since 2019, since that Australian selection. So yeah, very memorable tone to his voice. And it starts quite nice, maybe a bit generic, but sounds good.
And I descend to the center of the earth.
Ooh, this sound, like in the background, it was something more like a tribal feeling to it. I really loved that, so it was quite a cool switch. So I'm taking my words back about it being generic.
I may be dreaming, but the atoms are awake. What you gonna do in the room? Well, Mickey, what you gonna do when you see? Mef-Ali, escape with us to the planets, to the Fleetwood Macs and the Janets.
You know, it's very nice, modern, upbeat track. It reminds me of something like Justin Timberlake. Or if we talk about the Eurovision entries, then maybe Laura Tesoro with What's the Pressure? I think it's a perfect song for Eurovision Song Contest. I hope it will still build up really nicely. I only find, of course, the visuals a bit cheap. They are not even really singing, just, you know, smiling and so on. Yeah, not really much going on, but the song is quite nice. I like it. Okay, I love this kind of really electronic sound which comes here now. So now it again changes the genre slightly. So now I forget about my previous references. It sounds really fresh. I love that. And yeah, it's a really good entry from Australia this year. OK, Okay, it sounds like Michael is also singing in this one, which I think is very cool. I didn't know that he is actually a singer. So it's very nice that this duo is now not just one person singing, one playing, but they're both singing. Because sometimes in Eurovision, it looks a bit awkward when one person, you know, is just playing an instrument. And we all know that in Eurovision, the instruments are not played live. So I love that. Yeah, very nice idea. Balls and angels. We kiss and matter dismantle. To see we don't own the universe. Not really sure what the song is about and why this keys was there, so we should take a look at the lyrics afterwards. It has a nice, fresh sound. I feel that it's not really developing much. I hope that now something will happen, because now we are already through most of the song, so now we're already in the second half of it. So some big explosion is still missing. I was really onboarded from the very beginning of the track, but I feel like my motivation goes a bit away, so they have to do now something to keep it there. Maybe you're dreaming, but the atoms are awake. What you gonna do in the real world, Mickey? What you gonna do when you see? Yeah, there's this touch of Aboriginal elements, Aboriginal words. It really makes the song special, because without it, it would be, yeah, I have to say, quite a bland, generic pop track with some electronic elements. Yeah, again, these instruments are coming. This, I really like. They should use this even more. And I think they would really profit from bringing some of these Aboriginal elements on stage, not just Zachariah with his, you know, traditional dancing on stage and his costume, but I would say that maybe some Aboriginal dancers, or maybe in the background, they should use some symbols like Lithuania did last year, with some of more like Baltic traditional symbols. This would really profit from that, to make it more unique and to make it stand out more in the whole lineup. Yeah, this is also very nice. I really love this kind of switch now of the melody in the end. So something what people can sing along. This kind of sing-alongs we always need in Eurovision. And I really love that he ended the song with this bit high note. So kind of, you know, like a good point in the end of the song. So it's a very nice, upbeat, positive track. I think Eurovision always needs more of those. It might be slightly more on a generic side than, for example, their old entry, 2000 and whatever. But I still really enjoyed it. I think it's a very nice and cute song, which will just decorate the contest. And if we take a look at the lyrics, they are, yeah, slightly confusing. I couldn't really grasp a lot of meaning from those lyrics. I would assume from the title and from the text in the chorus that they are talking more about that all people should be united, that we all have the same blood, no matter what kind of racial background we have or ethnical background. But on the other hand, I was quite curious what those numbers mean in the text. For example, this 0.618, to which he wants to spill his tea on. And I have actually learned that this number symbolizes so-called mathematical golden ratio. And it kind of shows us some figures which are very pleasant for the human eye. Sometimes you can find in the nature some shapes which correspond to this mathematical number. And it is considered something what is sort of perfect, golden, and so on. And in the song, they're just basically saying, forget about reality, forget about this golden perfect things, just, you know, we are all the same, all is great, everyone is great, we should love each other. And I think it's a nice message, and especially at Eurovision, where we're really trying to unite all those different nations from Europe and beyond. And now it's time to take a look how the European public actually liked the Australian songs in the previous year, because I think everyone knows that mostly juries were ranking the Australian songs higher than the televoters. But if we take a look, you can see that in the last 15 years, but also in the last 5 years, they're ranked 8th from all the 31 countries taking part in the semifinals this year in general, and 5th in both of these rankings among their semifinal competitors. You can see that from their 7 semifinal participations, they managed to be on first or second place 3 times. It's an incredible result. And for me personally, especially surprising is that their best result, their first place, was not with Dime Im and Sound of Silence. Also not with Kate Miller-Hyde and her Zero Gravity, but actually last year with Voyager and Promise. I have to say, last year it was sort of unexpected because they were not really considered such a huge favorites to win that semifinal, even though they were the closing entry, which normally televoters tend to prefer. But still, it was quite a surprising result. And in the final, we of course have seen that they were ranked much, much higher by the jurors than by the televoters. And if we take a look at the bookmakers for this year, they actually see Australia as country number 26. They see it below Spain, Cyprus, Azerbaijan, and Slovenia, but above Denmark, Latvia, Albania, and Malta. So I think this placing is quite appropriate. I think if they would qualify to the final, they would finish somewhere rather in the very end. Somehow I have in my memory an entry from Ireland, 2013 or 14, I believe 2013, by Ryan Dolan. It was also, you know, sort of innocent pop track with a bit of electronic touch to it and with some national elements. He had those huge drums and so on. But I have a feeling that Australia is somewhere around the same target audience this year. I feel that even if they will qualify to the final, then in the end, they will be just lost in the general lineup. But will they be lost in the semi-final lineup? So let's take a look which countries they're competing against in their first semi-final. So Australia will perform with running draw number 13, which puts them after Azerbaijan and Moldova. So basically two sort of slower entries, but before Portugal and Luxembourg. So I think in general, there are no similar entries around Australia, so it will help them to stand out. So I would think they would be more in danger if they would be surrounded by more of this kind of generic songs. For example, they would be next to Iceland, or maybe even next to Finland, which has a little bit of the electronic touch to it as well. So I think it's a very good draw for them. So basically they have all the cards there in order to help them to qualify to the final. But will it be enough? Currently, for me, it is hard to say. I think it will all depend on the staging. And if we talk about staging, I have heard that the Zachariah Fields, he's actually also an artist, and he makes beautiful painting, very much influenced by the Aboriginal culture. And they have already confirmed that in their staging, they will heavily utilize those kind of paintings, which I think is perfect, because already during my reaction to the song, I have said that in my opinion, in order to bring something more special to the song, they should do something like Lithuania did last year to make the song just to appear not as generic as it in reality is. So I think it is a very clever choice, and I rather tend to believe Australia will qualify to the final than not. But let's take a look what the Eurovision fans think about this one and how high they rated in the Eurovision Scoreboard app. So at the moment of filming of this reaction, in the Eurovision Scoreboard app, Australia is ranked 30th. So it is above Malta, Germany, San Marino, but below Azerbaijan, Finland and Czechia. So yeah, of course, it's not really very promising for them, especially because in 2019, they were actually a fan favorite to win the Australian selection. So I was hoping that now when they got their chance to represent Australian Eurovision, they would be very much hyped by the fandom, but it's not the fact. So yeah, I will just keep the fingers crossed that they can qualify. So this is what I thought about Australian entry this year. I haven't heard most of the songs from the first semi-final yet, so it is hard for me to really predict if they qualify or not, but based on their running draw, based on some of the ideas which they have for their live performance, and remembering their live performance from the 2019 selection where they were so full of energy and so full of charisma, I tend to believe that they will qualify to the final. So please let me know down below in the comments if you agree, or do you see some of these points differently? I'm very curious to hear your opinion, and I'm very, very much looking forward to see you in my next review video. Bye bye.